Candlestick Park, a stadium that has housed numerous championship teams, plays host for this exciting matchup between the Eagles and the 49ers. This is a game today that could come down to the two running backs, two of the real stars of the sport, two players who went in fantasy drafts really high. How do you see this one going down today?
Yeah, and how's your fantasy team?
Man, we won't talk about that.
Let's talk about good things. But, you know, these two teams are stars. You know why? Because we can see how the football team is built. And I think it is no doubt about it. The offensive line's a big part of it. They always have hope. If they block their guy a little bit, these running backs can make a big play out of it.
Steps out of bounds. Up in the pistol formation. First and 10. McCoy. They knocked him down behind the line of scrimmage.
So many things you could do on first down, and what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
Michael Vick will be under center. Second and 11. Long ball to DeSean Jackson, and it's incomplete.
Well, the defense has got to be happy about this situation. Anytime early in the game you get an offense at third and long, you are looking to make a play and get things rolling on your side.
Cooper's lined up in the slot. Third and 11. Trying to work that left side. LeSean McCoy with a nice piece of running on that play.
They rip off the long running play early in this game.
This offense, every week they come up with new ways to run the football. I haven't seen that play before. Caught the defense by surprise, and it picked up big yards. Well, we got the mojo flowing today, don't we? You start out the game, it's early, you pick up a couple first downs, and you think you can't be stopped.
Cooper's a receiver in the slot. First and 10, looks to his left, running to the left side, bringing the play to an end. How you perform inside the red zone is often the difference in a game, and we'll get an early taste of that.
No doubt about it, Jim. You got to be creative when you get in the red zone. We'll see what the offense calls.
Here they come, back to the line after picking up over 20 yards on that last play. Nice tackle. They're just grinding away down here, inching closer to the end zone.
Well, that's what you got to do sometimes. It's hard always to think that you're going to come out and just make big plays. You got to do the dirty work, and this offense is doing it right now. That time, I got to blame the running back. He made a bad read. His vision was terrible. He makes the wrong decision, and it cost his team yards lost.
Third and goal from the 2. They hand it off to him again. They've got him behind the line of scrimmage.
It's third and goal. You don't get it in the end zone. What do you do now? I think you go for it. You call the right play. Give your team a chance to put a touchdown on the board.
Running it like it's an option play. And he's in for the touchdown.
This is why a head coach gets paid so much money. You get in situations like this, they have to make the call on fourth and goal. He goes for it, and they get it. Eagle.
Lining up now for the 2. They're running the option. Here's the pitch. Got the touchdown. Got the 2-point conversion. People love to go for 2 in this game, don't they?
Well, they do, and you know what? Now I guess you and I just can't sit here and blast the coach for a bad decision. When you pick up the 2 points, you can't complain about what they're trying to do.
And they're all over him at the 18-yard line. Offense lines up here. First and 10. Gore is going to take the handoff now.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
And Manningham's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Trying to make something happen. Challenging the defenders to the right side.
The defense has really done a good job here in this drive. They got this offense in a third and long situation. Let's see if they can convert it.
It's third down coming up. Setting up a little screen. Makes the catch. So a three and out.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third and long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
All set to punt here. Signals right away. Fair catch. Vic will be under center. Midway through the first, looking to the right side and throwing. Inhales the pass. He's into the open. In the books. Touchdown.
What a terrible job by the defense. That time, nobody even covers the receiver. He is wide open down the field, and hey, nice job by the quarterback going through his progression. He finds the open guy and gets a touchdown pass.
Eagles getting set for the kickoff. They stop him from running it out to the 20. Mark him down at the 19. And Manningham's in the slot. First and 10. Running back gets it on the handoff. 5 yard total.
Power running. A lot of teams in this league don't even do it anymore. This team, they can power it up in there and pick up those tough yards.
They go up the middle. He'll be taken down about 3 yards short of the first. Frank Gore is in the backfield. Third and three. And the give to Frank Gore. That's a gain of 8.
Excellent job of just picking up the first down. This offense is hot. Another first down, and they are moving down the field.
And Manningham's lined up now as a slot receiver. They tackle him for a loss.
Now the play is there to be made, but the offensive player doesn't get it done. Bad job on first down.
Kaepernick from the gun. Going to take off with it. And he's going to be tackled right around the 31-yard line. On the way, third down. Going across the middle, he had no time to get set.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything, and it's going to work, and they stop the offense that time.
The tackle was made. Michael Vick will be under center. First and 10. On the run. Working that left side. Wide open for the catch.
There's nothing like a play action pass when the offensive linemen make it look like it's a run. The linebackers are all near the line of scrimmage and easy to throw it down the field for that completion.
Jackson's lined up in the slot. They run the counter play.
has some space to work with.
LeSean McCoy with a nice piece of running on that play.
Well, when you give up a running play that's long, you got to say this to the defense. You did not hustle enough. If you are hustling, when that running back makes that secondary move, you got to be there to make the tackle. Swarm the football, that's how you stop long runs.
Someone's been injured out there. Hold on a minute.
By the looks of that, you can tell it looks like a major injury, and it's a tough sport, a lot of big hits, and I hope he's going to be okay.
That was a big gainer. Now it's time to back it up. And that's a big tackle behind the line of scrimmage.
Got to give the defense some credit. On first down, there's so many things the offense can do. They were ready for that play, and they stopped it.
Pitches it back. Reed makes the tackle.
Well, if you're a good running back, when there's not a lot there, you find a way to make some extra yards. Here in the red zone, it's even more important.
Nickel formation for the defense here. Third and goal from the four. Throws to the right. That pass incomplete.
Big decision for the coach this time, Jim. You failed on third and goal. What do? Do you go for it? I say you call the play and you try to put up 7 points.
The quarter is about to end. One more play first. Fourth down. Goal to go.
He's in for the touchdown.
The head coach decides he wants to be the aggressor in this situation. On fourth and goal, he goes for it. Nice play call that time.
They're going to bypass the point after and try to pick up the two-point conversion. And so put down a touchdown and a two-point conversion on that occasion.
Yeah, good job by the offense. They executed the play perfectly, and they got in the end zone, like you said, and got that 2 points.
Tackled at the 13th. And Crabtree's a receiver in the slot. And he'll go to the left. That wraps up the first quarter here in San Francisco. We'll be back in just a moment for the start of the second. The 49ers on offense here to start the second quarter. Davis is a receiver all the way out to the right. Here's the handoff, running off tackle.
A lot of ways to get plays in the NFL. It doesn't always have to be by a pass. Good job that time by the running back.
Gore's lined up now as the running back behind the quarterback. Middle and gains about one.
Well, I know it's not going to make a highlight film, but still a good solid run up in there for a couple yards.
McDonald's usually a tight end, but he's in the backfield this time. It's a second and nine. They'll run with it again. Has the first down and a whole lot more. Impressive piece of running by Gore.
Find a way to score. That's always the mantra with every team when they get in the red zone. If you punch it in here, even though you're down by more than seven, it'll give you confidence for the rest of the game.
The offense back to the line after the 60-yard gainer on the previous play.
I think you got to be a little more creative in the red zone than this. When you just line up and run the football like that, you're not going to get a lot of yards.
Touchdown!
That was a sweet touchdown right there. Just a nice throw by the quarterback. He put it right on the money. The receiver makes the catch. Beautiful touchdown.
Lining up now for the two-point conversion. He gets the toss. You talk about momentum. That turns into an 8-point trip, a touchdown, and the two.
This offense and the head coach and the offensive coordinator, they're all aggressive. So, hey, well, it's not good enough just to get a touchdown. They want to get that extra point or 2 points. Nice job that time.
DeSean Jackson with a chance here on the kickoff. Ball is out.
It'll be interesting to see after that fumble by the kick return team. Will we still have the same returner when they come back out on the field? I don't think so. That was a big mistake. I think they need a replacement.
Michael Vick will be under center. First and 10. He's looking to the right here on this throw. Almost intercepted.
This is frustrating for a coach. You call a play, you get the receiver down the field on a corner route, and your quarterback cannot put it on the target.
KC's a running back normally, but this time lined up as a receiver in the slot. He's brought down at the 25-yard line.
When you run the football like this and you show toughness, there is no doubt when you fake it and try to throw the football down the field, the quarterback's going to have all day to get it done.
Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
Terrible call that time by the coach. The defense was expecting run. They were up there. They were aggressive, crowd the line of scrimmage. And you just played right into their hands, and they got the tackle for the loss.
Michael Vick will take it from the gun, looking for an open receiver on the right. They've got him down there.
I guess that's how we're going to be today, isn't it? We're just going to go for it on fourth down. That time they go for it, and they get it. Good job.
LeSean McCoy is in the backfield. First and 10. Eyeing that left side. Incomplete, almost going in the other direction.
That's a nice route that time by the wide receiver, running the corner route, and the quarterback just throws it too far and misses it.
Nickel formation here for the defense. Second and 10. Counter run here. He's going to be swallowed up behind the line.
Well, these plays do look ugly when they don't work. It's second down, and you run the running play hoping to pick up a few yards to make third down easier. But when you lose yards like this, third long, tough to do.
Third down and 12. He'll fire it out to the left. Ball's picked off. Out of bounds.
That interception is strictly on the quarterback. When you make bad decisions, I don't care how good you can throw the football. The results, usually it's going to turn into an interception.
And Crabtree is going to get set in the slot for this snap. Frank Gore gets it here.
When you make play calls like that, you're not going to win many football games. That was a terrible call here on first down.
Second down coming up. Gore drives ahead, and now they'll be on the other side of the 50 after this play. Third down on the way. Play fake here. He's scrambling now. He's got some daylight. He's brought down. That's going to bring up fourth down.
This defense you're playing against, they're pretty good. So it's fourth down near midfield. Punt the football.
And the give to Frank Gore.
Well, they don't get it on fourth down. That was a quick drive, wasn't it, Jim? That was just bad play calling, bad execution. And go to the sideline. That's where you deserve to be.
The 49ers with a nickel look here on defense. Gets away from the pressure. And he'll step out of bounds. We've hit the 2-minute warning here in the first half. And here we have second down. Throws the pass. That ball is rifled to DeSean Jackson, who makes the catch.
Well, it was a nice throw by the quarterback that time to get just enough yards to pick up the first down.
Michael Vick will be under center. Vic dropping back the pass once again. He makes the catch.
We see this type of play by every team in the NFL now. You can't throw these back shoulder passes. That time on a post route, what a throw, what a catch. Nice play.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. Knocked to the deck by Willis.
Not a good job by the quarterback that time. Inside of 2 minutes of the first half, you got to get rid of the football. Nobody's open, just throw it away. That time, he loses yards by taking the sack.
Offense a little too slow getting set at the line on that one.
Offense. Still second down.
Hooper in the slot. Second and 22. Got a hand on it, and it's incomplete.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position. Nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
The pass play fails to work, and now it's third down.
Wasting no time. Here's the toss to the outside.
Jim, when you get in these situations, there's not much you can do. Third long, not easy to pick up first downs in these type of situations.
LeSean McCoy is in the backfield. The running back goes in motion. Vicks looking long. Ooh, they failed to pick up the first, and the ball will go back to the other side.
Well, I'll give the defense some credit here. They stopped them on fourth and long. Well, they should. Take that back. I'm not giving them any credit. I'm giving the blame to the offense. Bad decision.
The 49ers approach the line, and they're going with their jumbo package. Shakes off the tackle, running away from the pressure. Incomplete.
Nice job by the quarterback. He gets quick pressure, able to get outside the pocket and keep this play alive.
Defense time. Here it's a second and 10. Scrambling out of the pocket. Loads it up. It's going deep. And it's incomplete.
Well, for some reason, this quarterback likes to keep trying to go deep down the field against this cover two. That's not the spot you want to go. You want to look underneath or right down the middle.
Colin Kaepernick will be taking this one from the gun. Forces a three and out.
The pass is incomplete. Number 85, the intended receiver. Fourth down.
They're in punting formation. Jackson's going to try and return this punt. Able to take the football out to the 28-yard line.
Six,
One more snap in halftime. McCoy's taking the handoff. And he's got the first down.
So that's going to do it for the first half. Eagles are up in this one.
We're back here now in this one where the Eagles lead by 15.
Let's find out the latest from the sideline. Danielle Bellini is there reporting.
I got a chance to quickly speak with D'Amico Ryans during halftime. His team has got the lead right now, and he told me it's up to the defense to make it stand up. He said, as a defense, you don't want to give up a lead, so we're going to come out and make plays to keep this lead. Seems simple enough, guys. I'll send it back up to you.
Thanks, Danielle, and now we'll go to the field. Frank Gore is in the backfield. Ball is snapped, and the quarterback tosses it to the outside. The 49ers come out in a bunch set. Second and nine. Kaepernick's turning to look downfield now after selling the play fake.
Knocked away, incomplete.
Well, the best thing you could say on the offensive side that time is the quarterback got rid of the football. Terrible protection, nowhere to throw it, just throw it away.
And Crabtree's lined up now as a slot receiver. Holy, we've got an injured player on the field.
That's a good job. He's able to get up and get off the field. And my guess is he's going to be okay. A little bit of a scare there, no doubt about it. That makes everybody nervous.
Frank Gore is in the backfield. They fail to convert here on fourth down.
Terrible game management that time by the coach. It's three downs, it's fourth down. What should you do? Well, I think you should punt it. He goes for it and puts his defense in a tough position.
The defense comes out in the nickel. Here's the handoff and they'll run it. They deck him in the backfield.
Offside. Defense.
Well, looks like the defender was caught in the neutral zone, Phil.
Yeah, he was. Good job by the quarterback. You know, he made that little voice inflection. That'll get him every time. His quarterback's a little sneaky. Man.
They'll take that gift from the defense and line up now with a new set of downs.
End zone bound, and he's got the touchdown.
That was a nice job that time by the offense, driving down for the touchdown to increase their lead. That really takes a lot of pressure off their defense.
They'll get set, looking to convert on this two-point try. Running a little college-like option. So from 2 yards out, they get it across and secure two extra points. The 49ers in kickoff return formation. He'll have a chance to take off. And he's tackled right at the 30-yard line after that return. First down on the way. Got a little screen set up here. The pass complete. A tackle behind the line.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
Offense lines up here. Getting away from the pressure. Breaks away. The tackle's going to be made, but he's beyond the first down marker.
Well, when your team is behind, what do you do? Just come out there and get a first down. That's a nice job by the offense.
This play set up by the long gainer.
They're going to get him here for a sack.
Well, that's a sign of a good defense. When you can sack the quarterback, when you're just rushing the defensive lineman, you don't need any tricks, you don't need any blitzes. Man, that's talent.
Here we go.
Colin Kaepernick from the shotgun. Challenging the defenders to the right side and sailing out of bounds. The 49ers with an empty backfield look here. Launches it down the field. Tough catch. Touchdown. And they cut into that lead.
When you're behind in the football game, drive down and score. They did that. Now the next time when they get back out there, they got to do it again. Show some patience and drive it down the field.
Well, this works out about 40% of the time if you look back on it. And so they convert it here on the two-point drive. They want the football back as they line up now in an onside kick formation. And it looks like the kicking teams recovered the onside kick. Baldwin's lined up in the slot. Kaepernick standing back in the shotgun, ready for the snap. And incomplete.
Well, Jim, I can't say that's great defense. That's just a poor throw and a poor route run by the wide receiver.
Second down. Kaepernick's back in shotgun formation. And they sack the quarterback.
The name of the game is hit the guy with the football. The quarterback has it. The defensive end, what a job by him. Gets by the tackle and sacks the QB.
Third and 12. He'll throw it over the middle. Hauls it in for the first down.
You just can't sit back there and play conservative defense in the NFL. The quarterbacks and receivers are too good. Third and over 10 yards, you play safe and you give up the first down.
Kaepernick's got it in the gun. Kaepernick gets it to Vernon Davis.
Well, I think we've heard this expression about 7,000 times. It's a passing league, so we all know that. So you got to be able to throw the football and pick up some first downs.
They've got a first down now after that catch. Escaping the pressure.
Good job by the offense. They're in the red zone. They're down by more than seven. But the defense, can you stop them and just give up the field goal try?
Colin Kaepernick under center. Second down, four to go. Gore's handed the football.
Good job by the offense getting in the red zone. Now you're down some points. You got to find a way to score a touchdown.
Play number six coming up on this drive. Just a quick drop back. The defense did not give up an inch.
That's not good timing between the receiver and the quarterback. The quarterback that time throws it too quick and too far in front to the wide receiver on the slant route.
Setting up in the pistol on this play. Looking to scramble. There's a flag right there. That brings the play to an end. That's an illegal forward pass by the quarterback as he went past the line of scrimmage and then threw the ball.
Yeah, it's a big play. Listen, if he just wouldn't have thrown it and ran, he'd have got about 15 or 20 more yards before the first defender could have got there. Really, a bad decision by the quarterback.
They come to the line, and it's first down. Running it like it's an option play. Breaks free. the Eagles get a first down.
Boy, after watching that long run, I'm winded. That was a nice job by the running back. Good job up front, sustaining the blocks. Offense got to be happy with that.
New set of downs now after picking up the first on the ground. Tossing it to the running back. Incomplete.
I don't know what was more terrible. That was a terrible route. Terrible throw by the quarterback. Oh, and what a shot. It's incomplete.
Coming up, second down. Vic in shotgun formation. The Eagles now move the chains. 25 on that play.
The slant route made famous by the West Coast offense, something that really I thought came in the league when Bill Walsh started with the 49ers in 1979.
Let's see what they do on first down following that huge play. McCoy is going to secure the handoff. And gains 12.
Well, when you get a couple first downs, it just gives you such great confidence. It makes everybody relax. And I always say this, when you're a relaxed athlete, that's when you play your best.
The Eagles line up in the pistol offense. First and 10, right back to him one more time.
Good job of the defensive line standing in there and fighting, and they hold the running back to a short gain.
Fifteen minutes to go, and we'll return after this message and a word from your local station. The Eagles offense has switched sides now and has the football as we begin the fourth quarter. It's now second down and 7 after the 3-yard rush. Gains 5.
Nice situation here for the offense. They're winning the football game. Now they're in the red zone. Let's see if they can come up with a play that fools the defense.
Cooper is a receiver in the slot. They're running the option. Here's the pitch. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us to fourth down.
This play just takes so long. That's why it doesn't work too often in the NFL. Fast defenses. The quarterback makes the fake. He tosses the football outside to the runner. Nowhere to go, and he loses yards on the play. Well, when you get a couple first downs on a drive, it just, of course, it makes you feel good about what you're doing. It loosens up the offensive play caller, and there's nothing like dictating to the defense. I love it.
First down here after the completion. McCoy's got it on the handoff. Going to lose yards here.
So many things you can do on first down, and what do you come up? You come up with that play. That was just a bad play call.
Second down here Quarterback, quick toss to the outside.
Not a completion this time.
He's got the touchdown.
This guy can do it any way you want it. He can throw it when nobody's around him. He can throw it when they're close to him. And how about that play? Takes the hit, but still able to put the football on the money for the touchdown.
So they took a second look, but the play on the field will stand. The Eagles for the extra point. Driving extra point is good. The kicking team now getting set here for what looks like an onside kick. The receiving team has the recovery. Plenty of defensive backs out on the field for this one. First and 10. Looking to the right side and throwing. Makes the grab and keeps the ball moving down the field. That's a counted touchdown.
It was a short route by the receiver. He catches it and goes all the way down the field and scores the touchdown. And the quarterback looks at the coach and goes, hey, it was a heck of a throw.
Lining up now for the two. They failed to convert on the two-point try, so they'll just have to settle for the six. They're lining up for the onside kick. They want to get the ball back. Flag is out. Tackled down at the 47.
Illegal touching. Offense.
That onside kick did not travel 10 yards. Jackson's going to get set in the slot for this snap. Ball is out. This one's going back the other way. He's brought down.
Well, that time the offense fumbles the football, but the defense hit him so hard, there's no chance of hanging on. Hits the ground and the defense recovers.
Now on first down, Kaepernick from the gun. Makes the catch in the open field.
This get a wide open receiver down the field. The quarterback, good job of finding, he throws it down there and he gets the easy touchdown.
They're gonna bypass the point after and try to pick up an additional 2 points on the board as they convert. They line up here for the onside kick. They want that football back. Right at him, and it looks like the receiving team has recovered. LeSean McCoy is in the backfield. First and 10, LeSean McCoy takes the handoff. Going to be a tackle for a loss.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the offense that time on first down. Now the defense is in a good situation.
Lined up in the pistol formation. Second and 11. And he is tackled down at the 38-yard line. Here comes the training staff as we've got a player down on the field.
Well, after watching that play, I think it's safe to say you can tell it's an injury to the lower body. Really big hit. Feel bad for the guy. I hope he's okay.
Fumble. He stacked up at that point.
Nice job by the offense at time. Even though they fumbled the football, quick enough and smart enough to get on it right away.
Rounds lined up as the single back. Time is beginning to run out here midway in the fourth.
Well, that's four plays and out for the offense, and that was bad. Bad play calling, bad play, bad execution. Go to the bench and try to rethink what you're doing.
Time in this one's running out, and the defense knows it needs another stop. Now first and 10. He's going deep. Intercepted.
That was a terrible throw by the quarterback. When you're off target like that, you deserve to throw an interception.
The clock's really become a factor here, and the defense knows it has to get off the field as soon as possible to give the team a chance. He's got a wide open alley.
Well, the defense, they give them a first down there. They're behind. They just can't sit back there and keep bending. You got to take some chances. Go on the offensive, on the defensive side, and just make things happen.
After the long gain, let's see what they do here. Forgive. He's got 4 yards.
The defense has got to be a little aggressive here. Your team is down. You've got to attack this offense. You don't want them to get in there and get another score.
We're late in the fourth, and the offense is just trying to sit on the lead. They break through. Tackle them behind the line.
Well, that time, the defense gets the tackle behind the line of scrimmage. Listen, I blame this one on the quarterback. When you see the defense in a situation like that, you must change the play. Don't waste one in the NFL. You don't get enough chances as it is, and that one lost yards.
Vic will be under center. Just 2 minutes left in this one now. Back in a moment. The defense comes out of the nickel. Third down and 8. A tackle that had to be made, and that'll set up fourth down.
Jim, the offensive coordinator, has done a terrific job so far here today. He's got his team winning. They're in the red zone. Let's see how clever he's going to be on this call.
A short field goal try on the way. And he drives it through for the field goal.
When an offense drives the ball, they always want to get something out of it, get some points. This time, the field goal kicker gets it done. He gives them 3.
The onside kick is turned away, and the receiving team has it.
quarters formation here for the defense.
Down the field. And it's intercepted, which should all but wrap up this game.
What a terrible job by the quarterback. Nobody's open. Tries to force the pass, and look, what's it turn into? An interception.
First down here. Takes the knee.
Leads us to second down.
Takes the knee.
See what they do on this third down situation.
It's the old Marino play. A fake spike and looking to throw. And they can't connect.
Defensive coordinators love this situation, don't they? Third and long, they can do just about anything and it's going to work. And they stop the offense that time.
Here on fourth down.
And this will probably wrap up the game.
Ball is out.
Recovery by the offense.
This game's come to an end.